Today, I'd like to talk about Drogheda. According to Droghedians, Drogheda is split into two sides, the far side and the far side. No one knows which side the far side is truly on, because Drogheda natives are too stubborn to admit they're wrong. The illusion of the far side, or the fast side as it's locally known, was created because Drogheda needed an enemy. So they had to argue amongst themselves, because Dundalk were too scared of them. People in Drogheda can't pronounce their R's. This is because the River Boyne found its way into their tap water and gave them a speech impediment. In Drogheda, the R's become O's, because they think everything is so cute. Paddy is the main character of the Drogheda simulation. Everyone thinks Paddy's an Elvis impersonator, but really, Elvis was impersonating Paddy all along. He keeps the town running off the joy he brings to the locals. This is known as Paddy Power. Paddy is the drunken compass of Drogheda, and every time he sings Hound Dog and faces north, he gets retweeted by a Hollywood elite. Scotch Hall is a social hub where businesses go to shut down. This shopping centre has an energy field that makes Drogheadian children do laps around it while they're meant to be in school. This spell gets broken once they're old enough to drink in the local nightclubs at the age of 13. Fantasia Water Park landed in Drogheda as a social experiment to frighten the locals, who are scared of swimming pools ever since the water shortages of 2017. The government thought it'd be funny to put a water park in Drogheda, because no one in Drogheda ever asked for it. If you type the question, "What's the opposite of Fantasia?" into your Google search engine, a picture of Drogheda will come up. A lot of people from Dublin emigrated to Drogheda, and their take on the town is that a herd of cattle would be better off in the Liffey. The rest of the Drogheadians never stop talking about how they have cousins from the capital, because people from Drogheda think Navan is in Dublin. Fusion and Earth are the two main nightclubs in Drogheda. Everyone who goes to Earth looks the exact same, and they all have the same thoughts. Usually, "I'm hungry," or "I'm tired," or "yup the town." Fusion is where the alternative crowd go. The hipsters in Drogheda are a lot more dangerous than the hipsters in other parts of the world, because their accent is so unique. If you ask them to repeat themselves, they'll go quiet, stick on Nirvana in their pair of noise cancelling headphones and refuse to talk, because you just confirmed the belief they have that nobody gets them and they're deeply misunderstood. The kings of Drogheda are the nightclub bouncers, who will only let you into their castle if they know you. Once they lower the drawbridge and allow you to enter the Chamber of Secrets, if they change their mind and realise they don't like the look of you, they'll use you to practice the ancient art of the MMA takedown before ejecting you from the settlement. There's a museum in Drogheda, and no one's ever been inside it, because Drogheadians live eternally in the moment and have absolutely no regard for culture or history. Some of my researchers snuck inside, and apparently it's just an empty altar that says, "Fuck Dundalk." St. Peter's Church used to be a place of worship, but now it's a courtyard for 13-year-old kids to practice doing wheelies. The main attraction of Peter's Church is the preserved head of St. Oliver that lives inside the chapel, because someone, somewhere, thought that would be a good idea. Many critics believe this head was stolen from the set of The Mummy Returns, while others say the facial expression resembles a man who just lost a house at Fairy House Racecourse. Namaste.